your life, one spiritual growth will not move fast or grow. Prayer, the personal Bible study, God bless them through the week of prayer, and we have emphasized the importance of prayer and study. Prayer and study, prayer and study. These are the things that will make us grow spiritually. If you are not growing spiritually, it is probably because you are not praying enough and you are not studying the word enough. If there is something that will make us ready for the end time, as you have seen in the seven seals, that the prayers of the saints are always there in the presence of God, what will enable us to be ready is our prayer and personal Bible study. And it is our hope and prayer as the leaders of this church that we will inculcate these programs, this practice in each and every member of our church. All of this coming 2017, this is just the initial plan together with our church pastor, together with personal prayer and Bible study, we'll be focusing on family. Our theme will be enriching our family. Now, how is your prayer life? Would you think, if you rate your prayer life 1 to 10, we have, you know, the other week during the week of prayer, I was asking the groups I was in, would you rate yourself? There were some who rated themselves 9, 8, but there was even a 2. Can you imagine rating yourself in your prayer life? This is 2? And if I rate our church as a whole, do you think we are praying enough? Although we have a prayer ministry, but how is your personal prayer life moving forward? This morning I'd like to present to you in our study types of prayer. The first here is the prayer of faith. And the prayer of faith will save the one who is sick, and the Lord will raise him up. James 5 verse 15. In this context, prayer is offered in faith for someone who is sick, asking God to heal. When we pray, we are to believe in the power and goodness of God. When we pray, I've already asked permission from my mother-in-law. It's not unknown to you that she had pancreatic cancer late last year and was operating on around January, and she went out of the hospital around February. And we know pancreatic CA, like Dr. Segovia, he didn't have 3 months that fast. And we know that oftentimes pancreatic CA, you will not need 6 months. And praise the Lord, through the prayer of our church, the prayers before she was operated on, and the continuing prayers of the family members, she went on good. Although she's not really that healthy, but having pancreatic CA and living beyond 6 months, that's an answered prayer. Amen, brother. And I want to ask you, she'll be happy. Although she's not here this morning because she said, I cannot sit more than 3 hours anymore. But she used to come after she went out to hospital. She has been attending our church. And she also blessed the prayers of the nurses in the hospital, the prayers of the church, that she keeps repeating that. It was the prayer of the church. And that's why she made the promise. When I come out of this hospital, I will be attending your church. But she's not yet baptized. She has not decided for baptism yet. From that to the Bible study, but she's still, you know, I don't know what's keeping her, but she's praying, she's thankful for the prayers, she's attending church. And we'd like to especially thank Pastor Pastor Bartholomew. You know, during the time the night before she was operated, I invited Pastor Bartholomew to pray for her in the church, and it had a great impact. He told me, I had a peace of mind after the prayer, and I was ready for the operations. Although the operations took some hours and hours, but I think the prayer, especially of Pastor Bartholomew, had really helped. And these are the prayers of faith. These are examples of prayer of faith. And I want to encourage everyone to always pray. No matter how sometimes it's just an ordinary flu or anything, or a simple toothache, or it can be as gross as cancer or arthritis or whatever, there is a God who can heal and answer our prayer if it is His will. Okay, I remember years back, we were giving a Bible study to a respondent from our 3ABN program. He was having now three times a week dialysis. So in a way, that's already very critical. And we're having Bible studies. And he told us a story. There were some Pentecostal pastors who visited him before we were able to start Bible study. And he assured him, you know, if we will pray for you, we can heal you. In fact, we have resurrected somebody who had already died in Baku. But the problem of that guy would give Bible studies, he said, I noticed they normally ask for a gasoline allowance for me after the Bible study, and it's not allowed to ask questions during the Bible study. But of course, he said, I don't really believe what they're saying. They stopped. Of course, I don't blame them. It was our prayer when he was transplanted and is now well and alive. In fact, I hope he comes to church. But he was baptized as I'm the Adventist. But the prayers of the faithful, the prayer of righteous man availeth much. That's in the book of James. And if we pray, and if we open up for this to the Lord, He can answer the prayer. I'm sure if we ask testimony from our prayer ministry group, we will run out of hours for the hour of worship for their list of all the answered prayers. And I hope we do pray the prayer of faith for healing. The next kind of prayer is corporate prayer. After Jesus' ascension, the disciples all joined together constantly in prayer. There is power in prayer. People pray together. Jesus said, if two or three of you are gathered, there I am in the midst. Later after Pentecost, the early church devoted themselves to prayer. Their example encouraged us to pray with each other. Although it's quite sad that during the week of prayer, during especially on the weekdays, the hardest night, I think, was Monday, Tuesday, Thursday. Years of few of us here, brethren. And remember that our prayers will ascend in the very throne room of God in heaven. If we are not praying enough, we are not praying enough. If only the veil will be open in our eyes, the reality of our critical time we are living in now, you would not want to stop praying. How is your prayer life? How is our prayer life corporately as a church? Yes, there are around 60 members in our prayer ministry group. But how many percent is that to the whole church? What we want to see in the coming years is every small group of this church is a prayer ministry group. Every Sunday school class has their own prayer ministry group. The youth years back have started to do prayer ministry. But unfortunately, they did not continue, I don't know. And we hope these coming years you will spend more time in prayer in this church. Amen? And we will make this a house of prayer. The next type of prayer is the prayer of request, our favorite. You know, this is our favorite. We just want to ask and ask of the Lord. We are to take our request to God. Philippians 4 verse 6. Philippians 4 verse 6 teaches, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. Part of winning the spiritual battle is to be prayer, praying on all times in the Spirit, with all prayer and supplication. Ephesians 6 verse 18. So we need to pray corporately, we need to pray prayer of faith, we need also to pray before the Lord all our concerns. The next type of prayer is prayer of thanksgiving. This is another prayer we often miss. You know, in our discussion at the Sabbath school this morning, you know, for every very particular suffering that we go through, we talk to God, we complain to Him, we ask for help. But sometimes we are receiving bountiful blessings from the Lord and yet we don't remember Him. Right? We often see the sufferings, but we often miss the blessings that God has given us. And we need to focus in our prayer, personal prayer time. If we say the thanksgiving prayer for the supplication, oftentimes all the other supplications will be turned down into few numbers because God has sufficiently blessed us already. And I hope to incorporate more thanksgiving in our prayers. Many examples of thanksgiving prayers can be found in the book of Psalms. Prayer of worship. The prayer of worship is similar to prayer of thanksgiving. The difference is that worship focuses on who God is. It's adoring God. Thanksgiving focuses on what God has done for us. Church leaders in Antioch prayed in this manner with fasting. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work which I have called them." Then after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. Acts chapter 13, verse 2 to 3. Another thing I'd like to encourage our brethren is during the first Sabbath of every quarter, we have what? Communion service and prayer and fasting. Again, I'd like to encourage you this coming year to make the commitment to join us in the prayer and fasting. It's not only a blessing for the person with the prayer and fasting about, but it is really a blessing for us. So I hope we have this prayer and fasting also, that more of our church members will be joining. The next prayer is prayer of consecration. Sometimes prayer is a time of setting ourselves apart to follow God's will. Jesus made such a prayer that night before his crucifixion. I'm going a little further, he fell on his face and prayed, saying, "My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." The prayer of consecration. I was listening to Mark Finney in the audio verse for several nights, and I've noticed prayer of consecration is different from your prayer. This is what I discovered, because after all the prayer that he is doing, he said, he would pray another prayer that he would consecrate that day. That day. It's a different prayer. Lord, make me a useful vessel this day. Our days much, much better and more better. So, prayer of consecration. The next kind of prayer is intercession. Many times our prayer includes requests for others as we intercede for them. We are told to make intercession for everyone. In 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1, Jesus serves as our example in this area. The whole of John 17, chapter John 17, is a prayer of Jesus on behalf of his disciples and believers. Again, if you will join the Discipleship Journey Program, and I believe it will greatly enhance your prayer life, if you can join the series of the Discipleship Journey, one of the topics there I've discussed is saying your prayers. It will help you a lot to say your prayers. Number one, sometimes, I don't know if you've experienced that when you're closing your eyes and you're praying, your mind wanders. Right? It wanders and sometimes it draws off into sleep. If you say your prayer, it will help prevent that. And one more thing that prayer can help is when you pray for somebody, you say your prayer in front of that person. Okay? I think I've shared this before, I'd like to share this again. He was a workmate of mine who had a marriage problem, and of course he left his wife, and every night according to him, his daughter praying, and then he had family prayer with the daughter is saying, "Dear God, please open my father's heart to forgive my mom. Allow me, Lord, to feel your forgiveness so that you forgive her." And the daughter was saying this prayer over and over again, and in a matter of 2 months, he cannot resist anymore and went back to his wife and settled everything, and now they're living together. You see, when you say your prayer, it's not only that God is listening, but because the person you're praying for is listening, it's one of them that you love them too. Okay? So say your prayer. Prayer of intercession, pray them. And you know, it's always good to be prayed for. Right? Would you appreciate if you're told, I will pray for you, and they really pray for you? So do that as well. Tell people you pray for them and pray for them. Okay? And include English in the prayers as well. The prayer of imprecation. This is quite new to me when I was reading this. Imprecatory prayers are found in the book of Psalms. Example, Psalm 7, Psalm 55, and Psalm 69. They are used to invoke God's judgment on the wicked and thereby avenge the righteous. How many of us are into this type of prayer? Lord, I pray that this person will get sick so that this is prayer of imprecation. The psalmist used this type of appeal to emphasize the holiness of God and the surety of his judgment. When Jesus teaches us to pray for blessing on our enemies than cursing. Okay, so I don't encourage you to pray prayer of imprecation. But pray for forgiveness. Jesus said, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, and pray for them that use you and abuse you. Okay, so may we pray this kind of prayer and prayer of purification. Pray in the Spirit. The Bible also speaks of praying in the Spirit. 1 Corinthians 14, 13 to 15. And prayers when we are unable to think of adequate words, Romans 8, 26, 27. In those times, the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us. He's grown in tears and in pain, yet the Holy Spirit communicates our prayer to God. So this is the praying in the Spirit. It's not praying in tongues. It's not praying in tongues. Okay, so we'll have a different topic on that, but this is not praying in tongues. This is praying in the Spirit. Four reasons we should pray. Prayer enables us to speak. Prayer enables God to speak to us about the sins in our own lives that are a hindrance to successful soul winning. Okay, so we need to pray more and allow God to open our eyes. The more we come closer to God, the more we know how sinful we are. Sin hinders God's power from working in our lives. And I hope this coming year we are preparing for a big event. Again, in SMS, it will be on May 25 to May 30. Pastor Taj Paklev is coming over for another relationship seminar, and we pray. We're working with the conference that this time we'll have more baptisms. Prayer deepens our desire concerning the thing for which we are praying. The more we pray for something, the more they become dear to us, and the more we become more really close to the person we are praying for, and for the things we are praying for. Prayer puts us in touch with the divine wisdom. Is there anything? Are there anything that bothers your mind and you cannot sleep? Ask the Lord's wisdom in prayer. So prayer puts us in touch with the divine wisdom. Prayer enables us to work more powerfully than we would if we did not pray. Of course, our prayers does not force God to do something or anything. But prayer enables God to work more powerfully than we could if we did not pray. Because prayer opens our hearts to God and enables us to be more receptive to His leading. So these are four reasons to pray. These are the last 10 slides probably. 10 ways praying actually benefits your health. If you are a religious or a spiritual person and pray every day, there is now proof that you might be doing your brain and body a huge favor. According to a new study, spiritual or religious practice may fight off depression, particularly in people who are predisposed to the disease, by thickening the brain cortex. So prayer helps thicken our brain cortex. Our brain cortex is the convoluted surface layer of gray matter of the cerebrum that functions chiefly in coordination of sensory and motor information. So it's very important that that begins, because the study conducted by Lisa Miller, professor and director of clinical psychology and director of the Spiritual Mind Body Institute at the Teachers College, Columbia University, included 103 people who were at high risk of depression. Their level of risk was based on their family history. So if you have family history of depression, anxiety, you need to pray some more. Join us in our prayer ministry. Join us in our prayer and fasting. On mapping their brain activity and structure using an MRI, research found that people who value their religion more and religion regularly pray had thicker cortices when compared to those who did not. The thinning of the cortex, especially in certain areas of the brain, is an indicator of impending ill health, particularly due to depression. So the more it thin, things become thinner, the more predisposed you are for the diseases. Thicker cortices indicate a lesser chance of suffering from depression, suggesting that prayer and spirituality really does yield some stunning benefits to the human brain. This study is just one of a slew of studies that have proved the exact same thing when we compare the findings of all the studies, we zero in on all the benefits praying has on your body, and I will elaborate them one by one. Makes you stress-free. Praying influences your state of mind, helping you to relax and thereby reducing the effects of stress has on various body organs. So that includes your kidneys, your lungs, and your it releases more stress. It is known to not only help reduce mental stress, it also helps feed physical stress and evens out your emotional reaction to it. So I hope you pray. Second, reduces your chances of suffering from depression and anxiety. According to a UK-based study published in British Journal of Health Psychology, praying can reduce your risk of developing depression and anxiety. It also found that you have a higher probability of being positive and less depressed if you pray at a place of worship. So this study tells us not just to pray in your own homes and in your secret rooms. Come to church, join us and worship. So I hope you fill the church every Wednesday. The most challenging time in our worship service is the Wednesday meetings. Which is what? Midweek prayer meeting. So we need to pray some more. If you want to reduce your anxiety and stress, come on Wednesdays. Third, helps you deal with emotional onslaught. Praying is extremely useful in giving you the strength to deal with day-to-day stresses. It offers you some quiet time alone where you can think and give you the opportunity to focus on yourself and reduce mental stress, especially when you are too busy. Okay? Busy is a common word that comes out of our mouth. Can you join this meeting? I am busy. Can you come? I am busy. You know what is the acronym of busy? Being under Satan's yoke. So are you busy? Being under Satan's yoke? But we need to break that busyness and start it with prayer. Fourth, give away common stress-related disorders. Chronic diseases like heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, ulcers, and migraines are all considered to be a result of too much stress, being too busy. Stress is the number one reason for building up toxins in the body, which not only leads to chronic conditions like diabetes, but also certain cancers. Who would want cancers here? Anybody? So continue with your stressful life. Break it with prayers. Number five, makes you happier. Okay? You not only drink happy morning or happy to serve you, but if you're really happy, if you really want to be happy, pray. A study conducted by Dr. Andrew Huber, Department of Psychiatry at the University of Pennsylvania, found that praying can actually boost the level of dopamine or the happy hormones. So you want the happy hormones? Pray in your brain, making you happier and more peaceful. This is important. Makes you a better person. The same study also found that practice helps reduce the level of one's ego by affecting the area of the brain associated with that emotion. So if you have a problem with a boss or a family member whose ego is so strong and very high, advise them to pray. So if somebody tells you, I think, brother, you need to pray some more. It's not you're telling them your ego is so much. It's too much. It therefore makes you more humble, less greedy for material things, and a better person. If we would have only been praying enough, this church would have problems with some conflicts, because we would be more humble, more less greedy for material things, so meaning you can support the ministries more, and you become a better person. Speed up post-surgical recovery. This is for surgeons. So, of course, when you are prayerful, this has been proven already that persons who are prayed for who have done through the surgical process, and I have shared with you, my mother-in-law, well, prayer can really help. So, surgeons and doctors, take note of this. Keep diseases at bay. Praying has been known to improve one's immunity. One particular study also found that praying also reduces the symptoms of asthma. I need to pray some more. The studies on why one sees this reaction is still on, so it's still ongoing. It's good for your heart. The practice of praying has shown a lot of benefits on the functioning of your heart. It is known to speed up the recovery of the heart after a heart attack and surgery. Apart from that, it also helps regulate your heartbeat, makes it stronger and less stressed. So, would you not want to pray more? Then, the last, helps you live longer. Apart from all the other benefits of praying, one of the most striking perks is that it helps you live longer. Longer, healthier, happier life by minimizing all the ill effects of stress and environmental factors. It helps your body heal better and age more efficiently. All this put together helps the body heal faster and beat the common ailments that affect you when you get older. How many of you here wants to get older faster? So, I encourage you, start praying. If you're not praying, pray some more if you're already praying. If you're already praying some already hard, continue to pray. And infect others with our prayers. So I invite you to join our midweek meetings, our prayer and fastings, and other prayer meetings of our church. Happy Sabbath, everyone.